We're going live. Hey, everybody, we're live. Let me just close this door because I got a new dog right here. The text right down below. How's everybody doing? Thank you so much. Thanks for joining. Thanks for arriving here. You want to check your volume? Make sure everyone else can hear it too. Yep, there we go. Loud and clear. You got my big mouth, that's for sure. Hey, everybody, how are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. This is my What Would Jeff Do? Dog training Q&A, where you're allowed to ask all your dog training questions. I'm going to give you an answer. If you've never been here before, welcome. I think we're at 444. 444?
That's awesome. Linda.
444. Bam.
Make right. A wish.
I did. I wish we make it to 445. All right. And I have an aggression rehab facility, behavior modification facility. We also do basic obedience and off-leash obedience based in Providence, Rhode Island. Hello, everybody on Spotify, on SoundCloud, on iTunes, on Google, on Anchor. If I missed anybody, I apologize. I know we're getting spread out throughout a lot of different social media platforms as far as the voice platforms out there. So I want you to know that I really, really appreciate all my listeners. Obviously, we're streaming this live on YouTube Live. What you can do is you can ask a question. If you're brand new to my world, though, you can hear me talk a lot about punishment. There actually is a proper way to punish your dog. Number one, you're not angry. You're not mad. You're not upset. You're not taking it personally against the dog. It's just a matter of fact, boom, you can't do that anymore. And now you need to know how to properly do it. But the only way to stop an unwanted behavior or to proof a known behavior with high levels of distraction is through the art of punishment. On a daily basis, we spend 95% of our day rewarding dogs. We clicker train dogs. We use their dog's daily food. We use tons of positive stuff. I'm not going to talk science here. But when you hear me talk about punishment, that's how you stop it. So most of the people that attend this show, that tune into this show, that ask us questions, will say, how do I stop filling the blank? Hey, Joel, how are you? How are you doing? Didn't even see it. Sneak right by.
She's stealth.
I am. What if you didn't notice you're there? All right. So now it's time to start. Here we go. Also, a bunch of people have been doing the super chat thing. It's a little dollar salary night there. Click on that. We can maybe get some date night money. We went out to a new restaurant this week, a Greek restaurant.
I'm not feeling it.
No. Okay.
It was just okay.
It was just okay.
Which is not.
No, that's not acceptable. I worked too hard for my money. All right. Here we go.
Okay.
Linda.
Hi, Melissa. Thanks for saying hi. Susan. Hi. Heather. Hi. Okay. Diana. Hello. What's your advice for my 8-month-old dog when we are watching TV at night? Can she be napping or just be on the sofa next to us? Sometimes we all cuddle. What would Jeff do?
Oh, that's so what I want you to do. First of all, send me one of them cuddle pictures, please. All right. Send me a cuddle picture.
Is that like your version of nudes? Send me a cuddle picture. You know, people say send nudes.
No, my version of nudes is nudes. All right. Just to clarify.
But nobody's sending you nudes. So like.
Well, they do. But I offer to show them to you, but you're not interested.
If you're getting nudes, I need to know.
Okay, fine. Anyway, so listen, you have an 8-month-old dog. You've got no idea what's going to happen with this dog. In 9 months, at 10 months, at 12 months, this dog might all of a sudden start getting aggressive. And you've been possibly potentially reinforcing it and actually training the dog. Dogs are actually turn aggressive, not because they're being mean, no one's being mean to the dog. Dogs become aggressive because nobody told them not to be. Too much love and affection often creates unwanted behaviors. I'm not against cuddling, but during TV time, I've got three dogs right here next to me right now. Okay, three dogs. In fact, I will show you. I got a brand new dog right there. See that Mal? Tex right there? The one that's right there.
The only Mal.
The only Mal in the room. That's a brand new dog for us. And we just got him 3 days ago. And guess what he's doing? He's in place, and he will always be in place. And he'll be in place for 3 or 4 hours at a time. Because why? Because I'll be up here doing work. So I would say spend more time in place, off to the side, away from you, less time cuddling, especially on the furniture. The dog hasn't earned its right. It's 8 months old. It hasn't done squat yet. Next.
This one's from Adelaide.
Hey, Adelaide.
Dog knows how to auto sit. If dog doesn't auto sit when I stop, should I correct it, remind it to sit with a verbal cue?
Okay, Natalie, how many times have you done sit? Don't have to answer this question. If you've done auto sits a couple hundred times, that means your dog, it is a known command for your dog. Auto sit means there's no verbal. Now, that's up to you. If you want to keep reminding your dog that it has to sit, keep actually then reminding your dog it has to sit. It won't all of a sudden get better at it historically because you'll keep reminding it. So what we do is anytime a dog does not comply with a known command that it definitely knows, you have to punish the act of compliance. What does that look like? Quick leash pop. That's it. Quick stim on the collar. That's it. Because if not, you'll always have a dog that is stubborn, thick-headed, selective listening. All right, next.
Pamela says hi. Tatiana says hi.
Hey, Tatiana and Pamela.
Next question is from John. I've been using my local dog park as a distraction while training my dog, teaching him to heel and ignore the other dogs if we walk by the fence. Is this a good idea?
It's a great idea. In fact, just to let everybody know, I'm on the new dog journey as well. I just got a new dog here, and I can't trust this dog. I've got no idea what this dog's going to do. It's never been in my office before. It's never been next to my dogs like this before. It's never, been in close quarters like this. There's like, we have two cats in the house. Who knows what's going to happen? So that's a great idea. Do that and utilize the off-leash park or the dog park for distractions. And that's on the outside of the park. Obviously, never go inside a dog park. They're dangerous. Next.
Keith says hi.
Hey, Keith.
Stacy says, first time watching live chat.
Oh, welcome to you. Welcome to YouTube Live. Gotta love it. Next.
Okay, now Keith has a question. Any suggestion on how to help my dog get over the fear of trash bags? When I pull out the new trash bag, she runs away and she's scared. I haven't seen her being afraid of anything else.
Yeah, I would start burning all your trash. So set up a 55-gallon barrel in the backyard. Separate out your recyclables. Put those in a plastic bin. Take those to the recycle place. All your other trash, what I want you to do is start burning it. End of problem. Believe it or not, that's what some trainers would suggest. Literally avoid the situation. So you and I both know the trash bags are fine. One time I was held prisoner. I had a bag over my head. It wasn't so much fun. But other than that, trash bags are fine. What I want you to do is this. Put your dog in place. Put your dog in down. Get trash bags. Put them on the ground. Wrinkle them. If your dog breaks command, what you're going to do is you're going to correct the command. I know your dog's breaking command because it's afraid of the trash bags. That's not what you're correcting. You're correcting the lack of compliance to a command. That's how we get dogs over, like, give me the list, like hundreds of things we get them over. Shovels, lawnmowers, ATVs, skateboards, basketballs, babies crying. So what you're doing is you're saying, hey, you just broke command. You can also heal your dog past the trash bags. You can also do that. Also, in hindsight, what you want to do from a very young age is you can get tarps, those blue tarps that they sell. They make a lot of crinkle noises. You can actually take their daily dog food, throw it all over the tarps, let them eat off the tarps because it makes all that wrinkly noise. Then they stop being so phobic about stuff. But for you, it applies to the first step. Next.
How many years were you held prisoner?
Do you really want me to have flashbacks right now?
That was the wrong answer.
Right. 767 days. Well, I don't know. How long have we been married?
Your go-to answer should have been 14 years, sure.
Oh, sorry. Sorry. And for anybody that was a prisoner of war, I mean no disrespect. I'm being 100% serious. I'm being 100% serious. Next. Well, I had a relative that was. I apologize. It's not what it's about. Next.
Bentley.
Yes.
I've been teaching my dog place with his leash on, and he was doing it perfectly fine. Then I tried with the e-collar, and he wouldn't go into the bed. Do I need to practice more with the leash?
Well, hold on here. If you have to practice with a remote collar. So I might be reading your question wrong. So if you haven't trained your dog place with a remote collar, it doesn't matter that they know it without the remote collar. So it might not be a leash thing. It might be remember, this right here, this is Texas. So if I push this button, it won't tell the dog what to do. I still have to train the dog. So what you do is you actually guide with a leash while you're using the remote. What I don't want people to do is just because the dog knows something and you just give the command and you hit the button, that actually can work against you. So yes, to answer your question, go back to a leash, but make sure you're actually teaching remote collar place. And I've got a video on that on my YouTube channel. Next.
Holly.
Hey.
Howdy. So happy to see y'all.
Oh, that's so Arizona of you. Thank you, y'all.
Hi, Holly.
Thanks, Holly. How are you? Great Skyping with you today. I'm really, really proud of you, by the way.
This next one's from Josh.
Hey, Josh.
Jeff and the beautiful Linda.
Damn right. Thanks. Stunning. Hi. Sexy. Attractive. Cute. Looking for love tonight.
Who next. Is you or me?
I always am.
Can't wait to see what you do with that Malinois. Love you both and have an awesome Q&A.
Yeah, right. Thanks, now Josh. We're doing a really long place command. Next. And we went swimming today. But
this one's from Stephanie. My dog is better with her reactivity, but today we passed a reactive dog. She whined and got a little nervous, but didn't explode. We passed another dog that was also reactive. She was fine. Is this normal?
Yeah. Congratulations. Just to let everybody know, if I see reactive dogs, I move. I, Jeff Gellman, with my dogs, okay, if I see a reactive dog coming down the street, I actually move out of the way. Now, if you're walking by a dog and it gets reactive, that's a different story. But I still will, like, I'm not looking to walk my dogs directly past a reactive dog. If I have an option, I'll move out and out of the way. Why? I don't trust that the handler might have enough skill set to hold back the dog. Plus, dogs break collars. They break leashes. They break out of owner's hands. I would hate to have an off-leash dog come rushing to me. We have before. It's not pretty. Next. So good job, by the way. Kudos to you.
Stacy, best advice for a 10-month-old who loses his mind when people visit. It's like his brain shuts off.
Okay, because he's in drive. So he's 10 months old. My question is, can your dog do a 2-hour place command? Which is like go to a dog bed and don't move. Can your dog do a 2-hour place command when you knock on the door, ring the doorbell, walk back and forth? If you've got kids, have the kids running back and forth. If it can't, well, then that's where you've got to start. All right? So the first thing you want to do is you've got to eliminate the arousal. Eliminate the arousal. Don't use obedience when the dog is losing its mind. You have to stop the losing of its mind through punishment. So here's a bonker. So say all of a sudden somebody comes over and your dog starts charging the door. You would say no. You throw this at the door and the dog. It's a cotton towel. Like, it's not going to hurt the dog. But what it does is it startles the heck out of the dog. It's also a punisher. Also, dogs hate projectiles. And what happens is that dog goes, oh, God, what was that? Ah, now the arousal is gone. Now go to place. Your dog should be on a leash. Any dog that's not under voice control should be on a leash. So you'll notice that most of my dogs never have collars on. My dogs are usually naked. Tex, he's got a remote collar on. Why? I don't know enough about him yet. I don't trust him. I got no idea what he's going to do. So, you know, and he's trained on the remote. So there you go. Next.
This one's from Adelie. How do you begin professionally training dogs?
First, do it as a hobbyist, as an amateur, as a beginner. Work as many dogs as you can possible. Intern under someone. Find a mentor. Do a shadow program. Find a rescue that's open to multiple ways of training methodologies and get dogs. Take your own personal dog to as many different dog training classes as you can and learn other people's styles and see if they need part-time help. See if they need a volunteer. Volunteer. Seriously, volunteer. Take 6 months out of your life, work for somebody for free. Work for someone for free. Get a job at night if you have to. Work daytimes for free, what you want to do. That's just not dog training. Anything, guys. What do you want to do? You want to be a graphic designer? You want to be in PR? You want to be, like, I don't know. Whatever you want to do. Work for free. Next.
Next question is from Mark.
Yep.
My 5-month-old GSD will place really good, but gets overly excited when a new person enters the room. How do I stop with my e-collar?
You could say no, and then correction, punisher. What level? Remember, when a dog is aroused, levels always go up. But keep the dog out on leash. Next.
BBY Ghosty. Hi, guys. I had my first e-collar session with my dog yesterday, finding his working level. I was looking for a little head twitch, but I didn't get one. However, I did get a slight eye twitch.
Yes.
Is that good enough to be his working level?
Yes, it is.
It was a 5.
Sorry. And working level, and never worry about the numbers, by the way, guys. But 5 is really low. So I would actually go up to 6 or 7 and see what you get there. But don't worry. The eye twitch might have been coincidence, too. Don't be afraid to go up a little bit. You're not going to hurt your dog. And if your dog goes, whoa, that was too high, just go back down. It's no big deal. Dogs are fine. So that's what you're going to do. And also, levels can go up and down during a training session. In my last seminar in Seattle, which, by the way, was fantastic, over 50 people. I'm still working on the damn pictures because there's 3,600 of them. I want to put the photo album together. Jeez. I know. It's like, Joelle, like, I want to pass this off to Joelle. Joelle, you do this. But I'm giving you, but what?
Okay.
You will?
Give me that skateboard.
Oh, my. Okay. Yes. It's yours tonight. Okay. Done. Start working your dog. Next.
This one's from Kayla.
Hey.
Thank you so much, Jeff. Only 6 months ago, I almost got rid of my dog over his behavioral issues. Yesterday, I took my dog to train in front of a busy store. He never reacted once. You changed my life.
Kayla, I love you. And I'm not saying it because you're saying nice things about me. The reason why I love you is because I can put out as much free information as possible. Big effing deal. Someone has to watch it. Big effing deal. Now they've got to apply it. That's the big deal. I give away everything I know for free. Why? Most people won't apply it. That's why I don't believe in, like, you know, non-disclosure agreements. I'll tell you my great idea, but you have to sign a non-disclosure agreement. Why? Who gives a shit? Do you think they're going to do it? Most people are lazy, so they're not going to do it. So what I want you to do is I want you to know that you have done an incredible job, and I'm super proud of you. Next. I love you.
This one's from Lori.
Hey, Lori, what's up?
Private one-on-one, first session with new client, 10-month-old dog, normal stuff, no serious issues. What would Jeff do for that first hour with the new client?
Lori, I'm going to yell at you again. Uh-oh. Why don't you know? You're charging money. What would I do? Probably not go for a walk. Work on some leadership skills in the house, in and out of the crate, thresholds. Get the dog used to any tools that you might be using. Teach the dog yes, teach the dog no. Tell them verbally to eliminate all the things that they're doing that are probably making things worse. Mm-hmm. But really, what I want you to do is I want you to have sort of like a loose idea of session 1, session 2, session 3, session 4, session 5. Have it written down as a guideline, as an outline, not just for the client, but also for you. So you don't go on to some wacky guy show and ask him these questions. But you know, I love you, Lori. But I think you and I have got a yelling relationship. At least it's one-sided, sounds like. I yell at her a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Hmm. Especially on the Patreon page. I really let loose. She has to flip me off.
She wants me to flip you off for her, maybe. Just because I love it so much.
If you get an email, say, would you just bang Jeff in the ribs for mm-hmm. me, please?
Yep.
Jeff, this is from Lori. Maybe you're going to start doing that just for the hell of it.
Yeah.
Just to use her as an excuse. Next. Okay. Next.
Okay. Chevy. Hi, guys. Jeff, are you keeping the mouth for yourself? D-A. What's D-A? Dog aggressive.
Yep. Dog aggressive.
Redirection.
Yep.
I thought we were past this, but apparently she still thinks she can get away with it. 3 seconds on high to tell her this is not okay?
You tell me. Muzzle up the dog, though. First of all, yes, I'm keeping the mail, most likely because the dog has been good with my family. It's been good with Angelo. It's off leash around Angelo today at the swimming pool. Imagine this, Malinois, naked 5-year-old boy running around. Who does that?
Everything out in the open.
It's all out there. It's all out there. So I think I'm going to keep the mail. I might change his name, though. But I'm going to keep them out.
You know what I was just thinking?
What?
Every time you say Texas, and I think you're saying Texas.
I know. That's why we have to change it. It sounds
to.
Like Texas.
We
I know. And I don't want to be disrespectful to his last owner either. So anyway, next.
Lori, I usually start with crate, place, walk with Pong. Too much for first session?
It might be too much for the first session. You tell me. But just remember, you don't want to overwhelm the owners. Next.
Oh, P.S. Lori just gave us $1.99.
Lori.
Thank you, Lori.
Oh, Lori. God, I think if I didn't yell at her, we would have gotten $2.99.
Probably.
Shit. I'm just wasting money. I'm losing us cash. No dessert.
Oh, if that ever happens again.
Go.
Holly.
Yep.
When teaching place to adult dog that braces as it approaches
the place fed, yeah.
Should I give more pressure on prong and or use lures initially?
At the very beginning of the sequence of your dog training with this dog, try both. Next.
This one's from Heather.
Yeah.
Is there an e-collar you can use on a 7 to 8 pound dog?
Yes. E-collar technology just came out with a micro e-collar. Go to ecollar.com.
They did?
Yep. They did. Actually, we actually can buy it off our website, but we're more money. So you can save more money. You can save money on Amazon.
I need
next.
That.
Okay, next question.
Gabe says, hey, Jeff.
Hey, Gabe. How's Hawaii, buddy? Long time no here.
He just got a new dog. Adelaide.
Yep.
Dog is extremely scared of thunder and fireworks,
yeah.
But it isn't scared of sound effects of them.
Yeah.
Only the real thing. How would you work
that's
on
a hard
this?
One. Thunder is a hard one because you got the barometric pressure. You really can't duplicate that.
Even fireworks,
you can feel, especially in my neighborhood. Your sphincter freaking vibrates. My gosh, what a freaking horrific holiday
you
this
like
was.
That, though.
What, my sphincter?
You like it when it vibrates.
But I don't have to freaking pay for it. I like it. Yeah, I'll take it free any time. So what you're going to do with this is, again, place command or down. Place command or down. If your dog physically freaks out, you can actually punish your dog. If anybody's out there, what I mean by punish is, guys, please learn what punishment is. There's a proper way to punish. It's not yelling. It's not screaming. It's not. You're not mad at the dog. It's an act of stopping an unwanted behavior to decrease it from happening again. It's actually like fact. For all the people out there that are saying, well, no, because if you do punishment, it'll have a negative association with the behavior. It's called imagined harm. It's also a bunch of bullshit. It's also, guess what? The dog already has a negative association. So you won't make it worse. What you're going to do, because you're going to properly do it. So if your dog's in place, your dog freaks out because there's an environmental, namely environmental, then you can correct the dog for breaking place. Then what happens is the dog processes it. The dog is calm. You can also say you can give a verbal good. Historically, nervous dogs won't take food, so you really can't use food rewards. And if the dog does take food, it's not that freaked out.
We got some more money here.
Craig, oh, 2 pounds.
Yeah.
Craig, nice. I'll take that. Thank you.
Next one is from Mono Xide.
Hey, Mono.
DM. I like that. Would you recommend finding a trainer to start e-collar training session or just jump right in and go with what I've learned from yours and other trainers on YouTube, 13-week-old Rottweiler.
Yes, I go with yourself. 13-week-old Rottweiler, don't do it yet. Wait at least one more week, and I want you to do it with food. 14-week-old dogs, we start them on remote collar. Most people that want their dogs to be fully off-leash trained on a remote, and they have the opportunity to start a dog that young, they usually do it as well. This whole thing about, like, don't start a dog on a remote collar until it's 6 months old. You may not own that dog at 6 months old because it's so badly behaved. So what I want you to do is it's all food and it's never used for punishment on a dog that young for obedience. All right. So what I want you to do is it's all food based. Your dog should be excited and thrilled. It sees the remote. It sees the collar. It's like time to eat, time to party. Let's have some fun. Next.
Susan.
Yep.
Knowing that Camo is reactive, but she is getting better, should I just avoid other dogs?
You don't have to avoid dogs, but start to do a little bit of creating space. Use a little bit of creating space. Also, make sure your dog's got a really good remote collar heel. Do those two things. Next.
This is from Craig. Hi, Jeff and Linda. I just want to say hi. Love you guys. You have helped me a ton.
Awesome. Craig, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for allowing us to help you. I really sincerely mean that. I don't take anybody for granted. I don't take one follower, one listener, one comment. It really means a lot to me. Thank you.
The next one is from Joe.
Yep.
Bringing dog aggressive dog in for 5-week board and training in September. She's doing great with prongs since I found your videos. Should I introduce e-collar as well?
Yeah, Joe, go ahead. Hey, worst case scenario, you F it up. Well, I don't, if it's coming to us, we'll fix it. If it's coming to another person, they should be able to handle it. Just do the – don't use it for the dog aggression part. September's coming up. It's right around the corner. So don't use it to punish the aggression. Just use it for basic obedience right now. Next.
This one's from Diana.
Yep.
Ex-police dog from Czechoslovakia has really bad fear aggression. She is a 5-year-old GSD, goes ballistic when sees another dog.
Probably that's why the dog got washed out, because 5 years old is a little bit early to wash out a dog, unless it's got unless there's some health issues. But if it's dog aggressive, if it does patrol, it's not that big of a deal. So there's a lot of dogs that don't do good with dogs. But if it's freaking out, it could have gotten washed out for that. Forget that it's a police dog, number one. Forget that it's from Czechoslovakia. Other than possibly if it's a well-bred dog, it's got a high drive. You know, I get my dog, I like German Shepherds from the Czech Republic, you know, frankly. That's where Kira's from. What I would do is you need to learn how to eliminate the reactivity. And that's done through punishment, through a bonker. And we've got some videos on that. And what you're going to do is you have to learn to bonk a dog. And what we do is at the beginning of the sequence of the arousal is when you apply your punisher. So you're walking your dog down the street, and all of a sudden it starts to target, and it starts to load. So it's like do 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 do, and then all of a sudden sees a dog. The beginning of it, ears up, head forward, chest forward. It went from to closed mouth, and it looked. Boom, that's when you apply your punisher. And again, for all the folks out there that are, because I hear this all the time, never punish reactivity, you'll make it worse. Prove it. If you do it wrong, but guess what? No, it won't. It can't be much worse. We don't usually see dogs get worse with reactivity. We see it pretty bad already. We only see it get better. So next.
Next one is from E. Gilberti.
Hey.
Hi, guys. How long should the dog wear an e-collar to condition before actually using it with stim?
We put it right on the dog and start using it. But I've heard some people say put it on for a week. Some people say probably 2 weeks. We just start using it. Because the way we train with it, dogs do fine. Next.
This one's from Diana.
Hey, Diana.
I always wonder, do dogs remember hours after they did something wrong that you were upset with them and they misbehaved?
No. Well, number one, don't be upset with your dog. Mistake number one. I'm not mad at you, Diana. I'm not mad at anybody. I'm just an intense person. So never be upset with your dog. You know, I'm not upset with my dogs. You know, I mean, my dogs do something wrong. You know, I'm not upset with them. They're dogs, right? It could be handler error. It's usually my fault. Historically, if my dogs do something wrong, it's my fault. You know, they're dogs. I'm supposed to be smarter than them. No comment. No, they don't. Next. What they do is they read your body language, though. They read your body language. So if you're pissed off, guess what? They'll be like, oh, my owner's mad. And you'll be like, oh, you know they're still mad about you, like, ripping up the toilet paper. No, they don't. They're reading your body language. Next.
This one's from John. Do you do consultation on businesses other than dog training?
Yeah.
Asking for a friend.
Absolutely, I do. Yeah, that's how I actually make a living, guys. I get paid for this advice, but I do it in long format. Like, you're not going to get like this. You don't get intense, Jeff. You get nice. Like, if you've ever done business with me, like real business, like there's been a, you know, it's a voluntary, you know, cash, it's a voluntary transaction with me. I'm very calm and professional and organized with my thoughts I'm advocating for you guys, you know, out there. This is a little bit different. This is like my Q&A show.
Have you ever had an involuntary agreement?
How long have you been married for? So
that's twice already.
Yes, I do. I actually did a social media consult with a preacher down in Florida. Literally, you know, the preacher creatures. Yeah. Yeah, it was pretty cool.
Preacher.
He thanked me afterwards for not passing judgment on him. I'm like, you're saving lives. Why would I pass judgment on you? It's like I wouldn't pass judgment on a client. I wouldn't pass judgment on anybody. But if I wasn't going to be professional, I wouldn't take you on as a client. But I still wouldn't be unprofessional. It's not in my nature. Next, other than doing this. Next.
I think this ghosty is bye-bye ghosty. I'm like trying to read, like, what's this name? Maybe I'm making a mistake. Anyway, bye ghosty says thank you.
You're welcome.
Someone needs to correct me if I'm wrong. Okay, Diana.
Yes.
I live in Montana. Can you recommend a trainer?
I can't. I don't know of one. There's not many dog trainers that I actually could recommend because I haven't seen them work. Or there's some really good dog trainers out there, but they're not nice people. Secret to successful dog training: be a very nice person. I would say I probably get about 6 to 8 requests for dog trainers a day, just to let people know, a day. So for all those folks out there who love to bash me, like, okay, fine. I get asked in your area most likely, like, who I should recommend. It'd be hypocritical if I recommended you because you're not a nice person. I don't care about you bashing me, but you're not a nice person. So finding a nice, good dog trainer can be a little bit hard. Just go onto their, just Google it, go onto their website, go onto their Facebook page, get a flavor of what they do. Hopefully they're transparent. You know, next.
Lori, a trainer told me that pet convincer could eventually hurt dogs' ears. Can this be true if I used it too much? Thank you.
Lori, you're going to be told a lot of things, okay? I get told the most craziest things from dog trainers. Like, I'm like, okay, prove it. Like, where's the study? Where's the study? Can you please show me the study, please? There is none. Next.
I don't know what this goes with, but Lori says I know.
No, I yelled at her. This is all her me yelling at her.
I'll always love both of you.
Good. Love you too, Lori.
Bad Shodi.
Yep.
My puppy dog has been having accidents when I'm not home, even for 1 hour, even though I take him out right before leaving. He doesn't pee when I'm home, only when I'm not home. Should I crate him when I leave?
Bad Shodi. Your dog should be in a crate at all times when you're not home, overnight, and when your eyes are on your dog. I crate my dogs. All my staff crates their dogs. The worst thing you can do, especially for a puppy, is not crate the dog. Absolutely crate the dog. It's not the dog's fault at all. That's always accidents in the home historically are the fault of an owner. Next. If you're out of the house for 5 minutes, your dog could die. Your dog could grab something and die. Easy. That happens all the time. Like, the hell with piss and poo. How about, like, eating something and dying? Next.
Adelie says, dog is food aggressive with other dogs. How would you work on this?
I wouldn't. I would feed my dogs in crates. I feed all my dogs in crates. So in fact, I did a Instagram story last night with Tex, because he stayed at my house for the first time last night. I got 4 kennels lined up. Girl, Kira, Tex. Tex took over Jackie's kennel, and Ronan. All lined up, all eating dinner. Tex is on the raw diet now. Good job, Tex. All the doors were closed. All the doors are carabinered. They all eat in 5 minutes or less. Bowls go up on top. Actually, I take the bowls to the sink because they eat raw, and I wash them out with, you know, hot water, hot soapy water, and then no food aggression. That's what I would do next.
Cindy says, I've got a dog named Montana.
Well, there we go. Does your dog have any dog trainer friends? Next.
Lori said, yeah, I would have given you a $20, LOL.
Next.
John Snow just gave us $1.99.
John, love you. Love you, John.
Gabe said, what made you decide to get a mal?
I didn't decide to get a mal. The mal came into our life. I can't share the story yet out of respect for the family, but I will most likely. So it's not like I was like, hey, I want to go get a mal. In fact, if you listen to me talk, I wouldn't get a mal. But obviously we have a mal, and I don't look at this dog as like, I wish I didn't have it. I'm like, awesome. I got this dog. It's been put into my life. We're going to rock and roll. There you go. Yep, and it's been great, and he's doing great, and he's doing great with Andrew. The biggest thing is he's doing great with my family. That's the most important thing. If you want to give anybody an attitude, give it to me. My family, no. Doesn't work that way. Next.
Is this another one?
Yeah, John at $1.99, Lori at $1.99. Thank you, guys.
Oh, guys.
That's right.
We might be able to go out on a date.
Nice.
Yeah. Stephanie. Do you think the 2-dog version of the e-collar is worth it? I've got a 5-year-old and a 16-week-old. Having one remote sounds easier.
Yes, it does. Get yourself a 302. Next.
Cindy says, Stephanie Davis, I went from two remotes down to the one remote with the red and black buttons to match the collar. Bought it from Jeff. Easy to use and get used to.
Cindy, look at Cindy, man. You're quicker than me. Next. Stephanie, man, you're quicker with your thank yous. Next. Cindy, you're quicker with your gratitude. Next.
This one's from Keith. What's the main difference between punishing for fireworks or punishing for obedience? Do I punish the same way? I'm using the e-collar, and that's my main way of punishment.
Well, technically, you're punishing for state of mind, but you're not, though, because you're punishing for obedience. Remember, the fireworks, you are punishing for not complying to obedience. Remember that. You're not punishing the dog for necessarily being afraid. You're punishing from the shrapnel effect of being afraid. So pretty much the same thing. Do it exactly the same. And you're going to hear a lot of people out there, a lot of experts, a lot of authors, a lot of trainers, all these people saying you'll make it worse. No, you won't. You can't. There's only two things you can do, reward or punishment. That's all you have. You can't reward a dog out of fear. It doesn't work that way. It just doesn't. Next.
Robin with a Y. What are the personality differences between girl and Kira?
Oh my God. Huge personality differences. Kira is more genetically sound, number one. Kira has got better hunt drive. They both have the same ball drive. Girl is probably a little bit more skittish, or girl is a little skittish. Kira's not, you know. That's a couple other differences. Next. American Cattle Dog. Yep.
I don't know what that means.
That's okay. 16.
ACD pees when she meets people 10 months old.
So you got an American Cattle Dog that meets people at 10 months old that pees. So I don't know if it's nervous, fear, or excitement. Either way, what I want you to do, I know this sounds crazy, don't have her meet people right now. Have her around people. So have her around people, have her exposed to people, but don't have her like directly, you know, interacting with people right now. It's too much. So I don't want my dogs to actually get excited when they see people. So I don't want my dogs to be afraid when they see people or to be excited when they see people. I want them to be neutral. Next.
Heather S. At what point can you use the e-collar for punishment with a puppy? Should I just use a bonker for unwanted behaviors until that point?
Yeah, I would. I would. Next.
Did Lori just give us another
dog? Yeah, but Heather, when can you use it? I usually wait for obedience. It's more about how well does my dog know the command. So if you start a dog at, say, so even at 8 to 10 to 12 weeks old, you're not doing hardcore obedience. I would rather probably use a leash pop up until, say, 5 months old before I use the remote. Next.
Okay. That's another dollar.
Thank you, Lori.
Lori, that's awesome.
Next.
Chevy says, Tex and Angela doing it all hanging
out. I know. I don't know if anybody saw the Instagram. You can go to my Instagram account now. Go to the live. Go to the Instagram live because it disappears in 24 hours. Next.
Adelie.
Hey, Adelie.
Is there any specific technique to using a dominant dog collar for a reactive dog?
Yeah, you got to make sure the fit is super, read up on it first. If you're not familiar with it, please read up on it. It's going to be super snug on the dog, and you're going upwards. You're going upwards. It takes the drive out of the dog, takes the oxygen and the blood flow out of the dog. Be super careful, but it's great for dog aggression, especially. Mm-hmm. Next.
Emmett123.
Hey, Emmett.
Oh, so I'll read this one, but then there's a top chat.
Yep, awesome.
I was trying to find my dog's working level on the e-collar. Hold on, I can't see. I was at 14 and his back leg started to lift up. I thought that was kind of strange. Is that a sign he feels it or was it too much?
Yeah, I mean, chances are he feels it. Go down to 10, start back all over again. Go back down to 10, see if you get the same thing. If you get the same response each time, then 14 sounds about good.
Heather S. gave us $9.99. Thank you. With a heart.
Heather S., man. This is good. We're fucking going on a date.
I never know how to get rid of it. Oh, yep. There we go.
And you all know where because we document our dates. Next.
Sarah, I love the side eye Linda gives you when you get out of line. That's the least of it.
You don't even see what she's doing with her feet. If I start talking in a high-pitched voice, you don't understand. Next.
Chevy. I'm getting sick of driving 40 minutes to the freaking forest to walk my dog aggressive GSD every day. If I walk her in my neighborhood every day from now on and punish the arousal, is that too much flooding?
I don't, Chevy. Well, first of all, Chevy, you're in New Zealand. Get over it. Go to the freaking forest. Okay? Come on. If I was in New Zealand, I'd be in the forest. Why don't you live in the forest? Why don't you have a little cabin on the rolling hills with sheep and stuff? Is it too much flooding? I mean, flooding is good. Flooding with guidance is good. You should see us at our seminars. Have you seen photos of our seminars? There's 20 dogs there. You want to talk about flooding? We flood. Flooding with guidance is great. Try it out, Chevy. But don't lose your touch with nature, buddy. Next.
I think Lori Hoffman's a comedian. She says, I'm super nice, haha.
Okay, I believe her.
Diana Armstrong. Thank you. I watch your videos to help my dog.
Oh, awesome. Thank you, Diana.
Bad Shody just gave us $1.99.
Jeez,
thank
nice.
You,
Bad Shody.
Thanks. Yazarino 101. Thank you guys for everything you do. You've changed not only my life, but you've changed T Dog's life.
Awesome. Hey, thank you so much. Really, it means a lot to me. I can't express how important and sincere I am when I say everybody, thank you. You guys are my oxygen. Thank you. Next.
I'm your carbon monoxide.
Yes.
DIY music biz. Okay, so this is the new thing, live. Am I live?
Hey, Greg, buddy, love you. Greg, we have a Skype coming up too, buddy. I'm doing YouTube live now. I'm doing YouTube live.
Well, it says, yep, I'm live, sweet.
Yep, right. Next.
Mari.
Am I live? Are you hitting your microphone, Greg? Are you be like, do you hear me? Next.
Uh-oh, I just went crazy over here. Mari says, yee.
Yep.
I just lost it again. Oh, okay. DIY Music Biz, sorry being late to the show, but what's the schedule? Would love to attend more of these live sessions.
So, Greg, I try to do Mondays and Saturdays at 7:30, but it all depends on my travel schedule. What I'm doing is, if you sign up for my YouTube channel, and turn on your notifications, I schedule these usually the morning of, and you should get an email over the course of the day. Also, I put them on my Facebook page. So Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube, the morning of when I'm going to do a show, I always put an announcement out there. All right? So, but historically, Mondays and Saturdays, this week we did one on Thursday because I was in Seattle. So we did Thursday and then Saturday. Also, they're a little bit longer now because I've got a second stringer that comes in, Joelle, who you'll meet, because Linda's got her own gig going on downstairs. So it's pretty cool. And also we're scheduling. So I don't know. I wanted to do a 24-hour Q&A. A 24-hour marathon. I can do it. I've got the stamina and I got the answers to do a 24-hour marathon Q&A. But I need somebody to read the questions. And I ain't getting too many enthusiastic volunteers. So Linda normally does it for 60 minutes. She's up to 62 minutes. And
59.
No. And then Joelle's going to help me out. As long as I put some, like, exercise equipment behind me, Joelle will do it, or she can take a little exercise break and come back. But how about if I do sushi? Will you do it for sushi? A little sushi buffet here? How about if you fully catered?
From who?
What? From whoever you want. Anybody.
All right, I'll see.
All right. How about desserts? Give them a little dessert buffet right in front of us.
I want apps and desserts.
Okay. App, like tapas? Nice. All right. Good. Next.
All right. Stacy. My dog eats stool. Help. I try to catch and punish. What else should I do?
Okay. You got yourself a shit eater. All right? She's married to a shit talker. All right. So this is what I want you to do. Remote collar, shock collar on the dog. And I've heard it all. Put powder, put pumpkin, put pineapple. What? So the shit tastes bad? Hello? Like, don't it already taste bad? It's the most silliest thing I've ever heard of. If there's one person out there that maybe worked, that's fine. This is what does work. Remote collar, shock collar on the dog. Set it up super high. How high? 100. By the way, when I talk about e-collars and shock collars, I recommend Dog Trot or e-collar technology. Those are the two main brands that I like. Garmin are acceptable and Sport Dog are acceptable, but I don't use them. Every other brand, I'm not a fan of. And yes, there's a big difference between remote collars. If you buy a remote collar for $39, $49, $59, it's probably crap. You're inside, dog goes to eat it. Guess what? You make the act of eating poop really uncomfortable for the dog. Extremely uncomfortable for the dog. And then you make the act of even like approaching it and sniffing it too long uncomfortable for the dog. All right? And I've heard it all before. Your dog can actually die from eating shit, especially other species. Next.
Okay.
Yep.
This one's from Mari. My dog Reese, every time he gets a chance to meet a dog off leash.
Yep.
What's OFC? Why do I not know these things?
Yep.
I'm asking you.
Oh, I don't know. Off leash.
He will dominate and try to hump. Female, male, and puppy. I say no, correct, make him sit, then release. He does it again.
Okay. Number one, Mari, don't make him sit. Who gives a shit? Do you really care if the dog sits? I'm not mad at you. I mean, do you really care? No. You punish. So what you're doing is you've actually trained it. Your punishment's probably not firm enough. But also, if you've got a dog that constantly does this, it can't be off leash right now. It can't. So then you're like, well, how am I supposed to fix it, Jeff? Point. What you'll do with, I mean, if it was in a structured socialization environment, we would fix it. We would take a dressage whip. As soon as it goes to hump, boom. We had a dog. This dog would knock down children. But you can find the testimonial on my page. It's from a woman, I think her name is Barbara. She was a news reporter, I think, or worked for a newspaper. I think she was a news reporter.
Yeah.
She had this 80-pound bully breed dog. It would knock down kids, hump them to completion. It would mount dogs. If it even walked close to a dog, it would start air humping, like that. We stopped that dog in about... Well, we stopped the dog from doing it immediately, but it took about 3 days to stop the thought of doing it because it was so ingrained. And now the dog can be off leash around dogs and kids, no problem. We actually use Angelo as the test dummy. Next.
What?
Yep.
Yeah,
remember when he came home with that stain on his pants? Just kidding. Next. So you have to use a punisher to answer your question. Hard, firm. But I don't want you to do that around other dogs, especially unknown dogs. Next.
But KOG.
Yep.
ACD, all excitement since she was a pup. How long to keep her away from people?
Okay, listen. I'm not telling you to keep your dog away from people. I'm telling your dog to learn how to exist with people. My dogs are around people all the time. They just don't interact with them. I'm not interested in my dogs interacting with humans. They're my dogs. I want my dogs to not get excited about people or other dogs. I want my dogs to not care about other people or dogs. I only want my dogs to care about me. So I'm not saying to keep them away from people. Please don't misinterpret me. Have them around people. Don't let your dog interact with people. There's a humongous difference. Humongous difference. Because you're going to have other issues that might arise with your dog getting excited to see people and blowing you off just to go say hi to people. I want my dogs to be always in tune with me, not care about anything else in the world. Next.
Susan Olson says, hi guys, I have to go, but what is a Mal?
Malinois, Belgian Malinois. Next.
Mari says, when he is on leash, when he sees a dog far or near, he will perk his ears, stare, is stiff, and when we walk past, he tries pulling, but I correct.
Mari, I want you to apply your punisher at the first sign of arousal. You're missing it. Got it? The first sign of arousal. Firm. Firm correction, small infraction. That's how we eliminate problems. Next.
Karen gave us $1.99.
Karen?
Thank you.
Look at you, Karen. Love you.
Stacy says Linda needs a bonker.
I know.
Yep.
She's got one. They're called her fists.
Fists.
And she's Italian.
Let's not bring that.
So you know how to use them. Next.
Chevy. I actually am going to live in the forest.
Good.
I've just got to sell my house first. It's the time-wasting driving there I take issue with. Ha ha.
I know, Chevy. Chevy, send me photos. Send me photos when you move to the forest, man.
Maybe Jeff will come live there with you.
Maybe. He's been inviting. He was trying to put a seminar together for us in New Zealand.
This one's from Holly. Great Q&A as always. Thanks so much. Love and hugs.
All right. Awesome. Thanks.
Russ, I'd love to do the questions with you.
All right. Maybe we'll invite some people up.
Some like guest stars.
Yeah. Maybe we'll make some. Maybe we'll have some guest stars here. Make a weekend out of it.
Yeah.
Put them up in the Airbnb. Put them up in the Airbnb. We'll cater the whole weekend. We'll go out at night.
Do it.
I think that's
the club.
Ah, I would do clubs next.
I would say the club though.
Oh, right.
And there's only one club.
Right.
Like the club.
Right. The club. Right.
Club.
Right.
Lori, my clients have been super thrilled with all my help and training.
Nice.
Getting so far 100% great results.
Awesome.
Much thanks to you. I'd be forever grateful. Love you both.
Oh, Lori. Thank you, hon. Thanks for being such a supporter on Patreon as well. Thanks. If anybody wants to go, it's patreon.com/solidcanine training. So, go ahead, Linda.
Russ says, I love the 24-hour idea. DIY Music Biz says, oh, okay, gotcha. That makes sense. Thanks for that. Looking forward to this.
Awesome. Thanks.
Jamal. Hey, Jamal.
Hey, Jamal.
He's saying hi to Russ.
Hey, Russ.
Kiki.
Hey, Kiki.
I appreciate all your free information. I'm especially thankful that you gave a shout-out to Megan Hart. With her training, we've made huge progress with Bronson and his reactivity. Thank you.
Awesome. Actually, I just referred. So Megan Hart is a trainer in Chicago that I can recommend. So she's in Chicago because I know her personally. I've seen her work. I've spent time with her. So that's someone in the Chicago area. Her name is Megan Hart. I think it's megantrainsdogs@gmail.com. But just look up Megan Hart. Look her up. So she I can refer to because I know her. Next.
Adelie, once a reactive dog is becoming less reactive and rarely reacts, do you allow it to look, just not stare or show signs of arousal at its triggers and reward if it chooses on its own to look away?
Absolutely. Absolutely. So what we do is we give them, we'll mark it with yes, and you can always do a food reward, but when you're walking, it's hard to do that sometimes. But we absolutely mark, when a dog makes a better choice, because there's a couple of things I do. I don't talk about much rewards on the show. It's like we live by a fire station. I'm like, that sounded like they need to change the batteries and that thing. What we do is we reward a ton. Most of my day consists of rewarding. Most of my seminars consist of punishing because it's a troubleshooting seminar. But most of my, but then again, I do a shitload of clicker training at my seminars too. But most of my day is rewarding. I reward for effort. And I reward for the dog making the right decision. But if a dog is trying hard, I reward for that. Next.
This one's from Debbie.
Hey, Debbie.
I was on a walk with my 14-month-old Australian Shepherd. A beagle came toward us with an about 10-year-old girl. The beagle started lunging and barking at us, which then made Gus start barking at him too. What should I do? He wasn't listening to me at all.
I'd get out of the way. If I saw a 10-year-old girl with any dog coming at me, a chihuahua, I would take my dog and I would move out of the way and I would take that and I would say to that young lady, please stop moving. Please stop walking. I'll get out of your way. Next.
This one's from Diana.
Yep.
Besides eating poop and jumping on counters, what other behaviors would you punish with the level 100? I mean, very high.
Eating out of a cat box, getting in the trash. Definitely counter surfing. Dogs can die. Dogs do die. Talk to any vet office. Any vet office. They'll tell you about dogs ingesting things. Fence whiting. Any more, Joelle? Active guy? Trying to climb over a fence. Those are the things. Next.
Here's another Diana. What do you think about... sending my GSD that is dog aggressive to doggy daycare. I can't make this out.
So what do you what do you think about your dog going to doggy daycare but not being with other dogs because your dog's aggressive? Most places, 99.99% of the doggy daycares out there, I wouldn't even bring my dog to. Let alone an aggressive dog. I wouldn't do it unless they specialize in dog aggression. They're going to miss the signs. They're not going to know what to do. They're going to think the dog is doing fine. They're going to give it too much freedom. And next thing you know, dead dog. Dog fight. Dog's going to bite one of the handlers. It's going to be a debacle. Your dog can lose its life. Unless they specialize in dog aggression. So we do. Your dog can come to our daycare, but only after it goes through training. But even if it's still struggling afterwards, it can go there because we'll know its limitations. And we also work with aggressive dogs. Next.
Bentley says, thank you guys for all your help. I wish I found your YouTube channel years ago. My dog has such bad leash reactivity. It's impossible to walk by people and dogs. He barks, lunges, whines. Any suggestions?
There's tons of suggestions. Wait, Bentley, you've been listening for over an hour, buddy. You're here every week. Tons of stuff. Immediately, number one, proper equipment, remote collar on the dog, prong collar on the dog. We have no problem using tools, guys, because they make it easier for the owners. They make it easier for the owners. Then what I want you to do is that teach your dog how to properly walk when there's nothing around. You'll probably walk next to you, proper heel, at your side, not competition focused on you, but focused on you, not being focused on the environmentals. Learn how to properly punish the dog for like focusing on something and recognize the dog getting arousal. Eliminate the arousal as soon as it happens. Next. And do a shitload of other stuff that has nothing to do with the walk. How's it go in the crate? How's it come out of the crate? What does it do with thresholds? Are you giving it too much affection? You know, like there's so many variables. We've got 50 things that we do at least with an aggressive dog to rehab it. Next.
CC.
Yes.
As a first-time dog owner, what can I do to out-train / rehab aggression? I have a lab mix, high prey drive, reactive to people and dogs, everything.
So, Cece, as a first-time dog owner, you've got your work cut out for you. You're supposed to be getting easy dogs, but you don't have an easy dog. That's fine. I don't shame you or blame you at all. But if you're a first-time dog owner, for an experienced dog owner, there's a million things you can do. If you just tuned in, Cece, you got to go back and listen to when I started. I've been giving advice for the last hour about how to handle this stuff. You want to make sure, and then also I would encourage you to do a Skype session. So I know you just tuned in, so you're like, well, that doesn't help me, Jeff. I just tuned in. I'm asking you for your help now. So number one, teach it lots of rules, lots of boundaries. Cut out affection. Tons of structure. Literally, cut out affection. Like, is your dog, dog's reactive to everything? No affection for this dog. None. Zero. Lots of rules. Be cold and uncaring right now, like a drill sergeant. Oh my God, that sounds mean. No, it doesn't. Your dog's making your life crappy. Doesn't sound mean at all. So what I want you to do then is teach your dog how to properly walk on a leash. Use the proper equipment. Prong collar, remote collar. Teach your dog all its basic obedience commands. That's not going to eliminate any of the dog aggression. But as a first-time dog owner, let's incorporate all of these things. For the aggression, you need to figure out what a proper punisher is that your dog finds that it doesn't like. Your answer is actually a 3-hour conversation that we would do on a one-on-one Skype. I'm just trying to give you a ballpark. But also, go back and listen to the show. Next.
This is from KOE. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Mari, thank you so much. Taryn, I don't agree with your training technique, but I love watching your videos. Is that weird?
Taryn, number one, it's not weird at all. And I don't expect people to see, this is the thing, Taryn. Taryn, you're nice. You're a nice person. Bottom line. See, to me, that's all that matters. You're a nice person. I want to surround myself with nice people. If you don't like what I do, I don't take it personally. I really don't. If you don't like my choice of food, my choice of religion, if you don't like the fact that I homeschool my kids, if you don't like the fact that I'm anti-vaccine, if you don't like the fact that I feed raw, I'm okay with all of those things. Are you a nice person or not? That's all that matters to me. So you're not weird at all. You're fucking wonderful. And I love you for that. And I'm being so sincere, guys. I'm being so sincere. It's okay to disagree with people. But are you an asshole or not? Bottom line. Next.
Asan, what is a good brand for a prong collar for a 35-pound dog?
Use the Herm Springer 2.25 millimeter. But also, have you seen me clicker train a dog before? Have you actually seen me train an obedience command? You'd be surprised. You would be surprised how similar I am to a lot of folks. Next. Colleen.
Colleen, hi, Linda and Jeff. Who do you recommend as a trainer in the Fort Worth, Texas area?
Fort Worth, nobody off the top of my head. There's a shitload of trainers in Texas, though, because you've got a couple of dog training schools out there. Next.
Mari says, what is the best e-collar brand?
I don't know about the best. I like e-collar technology, number one. Dog train, number two. Sport dogs are good, but they run hot. Garmin's are good, but I don't like the controllers. Next.
CC says, edit to my question. I have Quan Collar, which he responds well to.
Awesome.
Bentley says, thank you again. I'll be back next Q&A.
So, Cece, start your seat. Watch all my do-it-yourself videos. Watch all my do-it-yourself videos. I got thousands of them online. Next.
Karen, I'm currently training a dog who, before me, had gone on a board and train facility where they misused an e-collar, and now he is deathly afraid of everything the e-collar on.
Do I have any suggestions? So the dog was yes, by the way. It's an
even
owl.
Having the e-collar on, do you have any suggestions?
Yes, yeah. So, okay. But I'd like to have instead. Okay, go. Go ahead. Go now. So, goodbye, Linda.
Bye. Roll out. I have my foot. I need that.
Okay. Watch where your foot is. I can't see. All right. All right. So what I want you to do is this. We get dogs in like that. We get dogs that have had negative experiences with remote collar. This is Joelle, everybody.
Hi.
Hey. She started out as an intern, and now she's an official employee. Actually, not until September 1st. Not until September 1st. Thanks, Mom. Good. Okay. And what I want you to do is this. I want you to do shitloads of food. Massive amounts of food associations with that collar, as it should have been done in the first place. So that's what I want you to do. You can't take back what's already happened. But I'm telling you, you can change it. We've had dogs that have come in deathly afraid of remote collars because of bad experiences, and they do fine. That was Karen right there. Awesome.
Okay, Steve-O, what do you do if you are at an acquaintance house and their dog is jumping all over you?
What would I do? I'd leave. I don't have rude friends like that. So this is what I would do. I would be, can you put your dog away, please? And if they go, oh, no, he likes people, or don't tell me what to do in my own house, then guess what? I wouldn't go to their house. It's no different. Guys, if I'm at somebody's house and they light up a cigarette, I leave. It's as simple as that. Like, it's a free country. Leave. Next.
Cece, thank you, Jeff.
You're welcome, Cece. Love you.
Marie, when correcting Reese, how do I correct him? Do I give him a firm pop or say no, then firm correction? He walks on my left.
No, and then punisher. Next. Mark it. Next.
Taryn, I want to surround myself with people I disagree with. I learn best that way. You go, Jeff.
Oh, Taryn, that's awesome. Next.
Colleen.
Oh, no. Taryn, I'm never going to try to convince you of anything. That's the thing. I don't talk anybody into anything. Never. I would never. We're all on our own journey, man. We're all on our own path in life, right? Next.
Colleen says, thank you. Love you both.
All right, awesome. Stacey. That was probably towards Linda.
Yes.
Just to not take it personal.
I know.
We're still on Linda questions.
Exactly. Right.
There should be a little break.
Stacy, my dog eats socks. We don't usually catch him until it's too late. Barf, poop, out. We prohibit his movement from upstairs besides painful punishment, anything else.
Yeah, Stacy, I'm sure you know your dog could die. Your dog could die if it doesn't pass. And maybe it all might not be passing. It all might not be passing. There might be some women's lace panties in there. You know, there usually is women's lace panties, at least in this house, hanging around somewhere. My glove box, and, you know, my backseat of my car, and, you know. I forgot them. That was back in the day. I was having high school flashbacks.
Yeah.
high school flashbacks there. And then when I first met Linda. So this is the thing is you got to set your dog up. First of all, never let your eyes off your dog. Set your dog up with a video camera. All right? Set your dog up with a video camera. Have some socks out, video camera, and guess what? Catch the dog in the act. Next.
Cece, are you anti-vaccine for dogs as well?
Yes, I am, actually. But I have to abide by the law. So there's a couple of things. So I run a licensed board and train kennel. We are licensed by the state of Rhode Island, by the Department of Environmental Management. They oversee us. So theoretically, they oversee all the dogs in our facility. So we've got certain qualities of standards to abide by. So the care of the, not how we train, but that, but the care of the dogs. So the care of the care and condition that the dogs live in, we are overseen by. The medical vaccinations, we are overseen by. So there's certain things we have to do. I travel with my dogs. So I take my dogs up to Canada. So there's certain things that I have to do with my dogs that I may not agree with. Rabies, dogs don't need rabies shot more than once in its life. And in Rhode Island, up until a couple of years ago, we had 1 year renewal, which is the biggest line of bullshit money making scheme out there. I'm all for making money, but it's like, now we have 3 year, you know, but guess what? If you miss the 3 year date by 1 day, the vaccine's only good for a year, but guess what? Same syringe, same vaccine. So miss it by a day, all of a sudden that syringe is only good for a year. So yeah, I think we over vaccinate our kids. I don't get vaccines myself. I don't do the flu shot. My kids, one of my kids is going into the public school system this year. She's probably gonna have to get vaccinations we don't agree with. I think a couple of them we're actually gonna contest. We're actually gonna contest because we feel that strongly about them. I think HPV is one of them. Next.
A-son, what is better to train with, a prong collar or an e-collar?
Two different things for two different things. It's like, Jeff, should I have sushi or Thai food tonight? They're both fucking awesome. So they have different purposes. Off-leash, so for off-leash, a prong collar is useless. For state of mind, a prong collar is not effective. Remote collar is going to be a great tool. No leash on the dog, prong collars don't work at all. We start dogs on prong, we layer dogs on remote, and then when the dogs are off-leash, you only need a remote collar. Next.
Taryn, is there a type of dog a remote collar wouldn't work for? I have a 14-pound passive Shih Tzu. Will a remote collar work for his personality?
Yeah, Taryn. It's not a personality. Good question. So first of all, the size-wise, no problem. You can get yourself a mini educator, or they just came up with the e-collar technologies, micro collar. Remote collars are not last option, and they're not for bad dogs. A remote collar is the best way to communicate with a dog off-leash, either close by or at a distance with lots of distractions. On leash, same thing. But off leash, how do you have a conversation with a dog that's 30 feet away when there's tons of environmentals going on? Not too many dogs are under just voice control that I see, even dog trainer dogs. So remote collar, it's not about your dog being passive. Or put it this way, shy, nervous, fearful dogs, a remote collar is the best tool. I work with feral dogs. Not fearful. I work with fearful. Feral. Remote collar, best tool there is. Fear dogs. Shutdown dogs, best tool there is. I mean, a remote collar, to us, every dog. And I know it's like, well, every dog needs to be trained differently. Dogs can only do so many unwanted behaviors, and there's so many like personality types out there. It's like pretty much if you know how to use a remote collar for a certain situation, it's the best tool there is. It's the best tool there is. Next.
Brandon, how can I speak with you personally? I'm not comfortable with training.
You're not comfortable with training? What do you want to talk about? So what you can do is if you want to speak with me, if you're not comfortable with what I do, like, why would we talk? But if you're not comfortable with, this is what you can do. Go to my website, solidcaninetraining.com. Go to solidcaninetraining.com, and there's a contact form. Fill that out and explain things a little bit more. Explain things a little bit more. But if you're not comfortable with what I do, don't hire us. Don't hire us at all. If you're not comfortable, or if you need more clarification, I've got a lot of free stuff out there, but I'm never gonna convince anybody. I'm never gonna say, no, you have to do this. We do train a certain way though at our training facility. All right, next.
322 MSG. Hi, Joelle.
That's Melissa.
Melissa, hi. Brandon here in Michigan.
Oh, hey, Brandon.
Oh, he's not comfortable training here in Michigan. Broke his question out.
Michigan. I'm gonna be in Elkhart, Indiana. We had a lot of people from Michigan that comes down there. We had a lot of people that come down there from Michigan. Go to rvdogtrainer.com. You can also go to Chicago. It's probably worth it for you to actually give Megan Hart a call. But email me, Brent. Good.
Spinisper, top 5 DIY videos I should watch for puppy coming in 3 weeks. She will be 8 weeks.
None of my videos. I don't have any puppy specific stuff. Get yourself either the Monks of Newskeet or Cesar Millan's book. There's probably a couple other good puppy books out there. Get my buddy Sean O'Shea's book. It's not a puppy training book, but it's just a philosophy book. You want to learn how to do, puppies, we all clicker train. It's all food. You need to find a good clicker food trainer. That's all puppy stuff. And then you want to find out about the different fear periods in dogs. That's going to be important. You also want to make sure you understand structure, obviously crate training and housebreaking. You want to make sure you master that. Be careful about too much affection. Next.
DIY music biz. Baskerville muzzle. Do you find yourself patting the area over the bridge of the nose? My dog has created a small cut trying to take it off, rubbing his nose muzzle in the grass. Is that common?
It is common. What you can do is you actually can take really soft yarn, like cashmere-ish yarn, and wrap it around the bridge part on the muzzle. That creates a little bit of a buffer. But if the dog's trying to take it off on the grass, you can correct that. You can stop that. Any pawing, you stop. What I would do is I would actually muzzle condition your dog so your dog loves using the muzzle. We do that with food and a clicker. Next.
Steve O.V. says, thank you. Spinisper says, welcome. I'm deep into my puppy prep. LOL.
I know, man. Be prepared.
Yeah.
Who said that, Steve?
No, Spinisper.
Spinisper? I don't want to hear you bitching that you ain't getting any sleep. None of that bitching. I don't want to hear that it's 4 o'clock in the morning and you had to go outside in the rain because your puppy was having to take a dump. I don't want to hear about it. You're the one that wanted the puppy, right? You're the one that wanted the puppy. So be prepared, man. Be prepared. Next.
Brandon, Jeff, help me save Chaos, my kind of Corso Mastiff.
Okay. I can only do so much from over here. Go to my seminar, but fill out the form. Fill out the form. There's got to be good dog trainers in Michigan. There has to be somebody. But fill out the form. I can only do so much in this thing. I do Skypes, guys. That's how I make a living. I mean, I own a dog training company. I travel the world doing dog training seminars. But my day-to-day basis, other than running my company, is I do about 3 to 4 on a normal day. 3 to 4 Skypes around the world a day. Like it's from a consultant basis. I mean, that's sort of my gig. You know what I mean? So those are really helpful. Also, join my Patreon page. Next.
Mackenzie Jordan. I'm so excited for the Canton seminar. Mackenzie. I can't wait.
Oh, my gosh. I can't wait. Want to go to that one?
Sure.
Okay. Go to that one.
Great.
Okay. So you'll meet Joelle, too. She's gonna be my road trip buddy. So what you're going to do is the Canton, Ohio one, I'm excited, too. Brand new venue for me. It's actually a brand new venue for Eric, who's the host. Next.
Stacy, looking forward to the South Carolina training, hoping I can make it.
All right. Stacy, put your butt down there. And if everyone doesn't know about my seminars, you can go to rvdogtrainer.com. rvdogtrainer.com. Why? Because I drive around in my RV. Next.
Tatjana, I made a mistake, let guest, which came for the first time to the house, to approach and pet my dog. Man did it wrongly, put his hand around her mouth, and she tried to bite his hand.
Grab yourself a bonker, right, like this. Put in your right hand and hit yourself in the head with it, right? Lesson learned. Next.
A-son says, thank you.
You're welcome, A-son.
Tatjana, even I know it's my mistake. I'm worried about that reaction. Is she allowed to act like that? Should I punish it?
This is the thing. I don't let people pet my dogs. And my dogs are social. I don't trust people. So are you trying to say that your dog, that this person grabbed, does it sound like someone grabbed the dog's muzzle?
By its muzzle.
I freaking kicked that person out of my house.
Yeah.
Like, that's why I don't let people touch my dogs. Everybody's like, does something different. Like, I just got a new dog here. I'm super careful with that dog. Number one, it's a male. Like, you got to be careful about getting up. And that dog knows bite work. Because I did some bite work with it today.
Did you hear him scream?
Yeah. So I mean, like, so I've got a dog that does bite work. So I need to know everything about that dog. I need to know every one of its triggers. So I got to be super careful. I got to be super careful. So, you know, this is the thing. It's, and all dogs can, I mean, controlled biting and uncontrolled biting are two different things, but I don't let anybody touch my freaking dogs. Next.
Stacy, working on extending place now. Thanks so much. I didn't like my puppy until he was 6 months in part because I found you and felt I had some tools for correcting his unwanted behavior.
Awesome.
Brandon says, I'm a trainer in Michigan with top 5 trainer.
There you go. And Brandon, I don't normally let people advertise their services on my page because I don't know anything about Brandon. But what I would say is, that doesn't mean you shouldn't give Brandon a call. So give Brandon a call, check Brandon out. And hey, you know where to find him, right? So that's what you can do. That's what you can do. Thanks, Brandon. But it's a habit. I don't let people like promote themselves. I would actually normally block people. But Brandon, I'm not going to block you. Don't worry.
Scully, my girlfriend is completing the year and she is watching her live speaks. She, I don't know what that is. She does not know how to speak English. I'm from Brazil.
Okay. Do you have a question? Scully, I'm confused. Congratulations to your girlfriend. Congratulations to you. I don't speak Portuguese. Sorry.
Melissa's posting your seminar dates.
Oh, awesome.
DIY Music Biz says, gotcha. CC Wheeler, in reference to too much affection, when is it appropriate?
All depends on your dog. It all depends on what you're doing with your dog. Do you know that people are training their dogs to be aggressive, nervous, fearful, and reactive with affection, but not on purpose? I see it all the time. I'm constantly seeing dogs displaying all the unwanted behaviors, and I'm seeing humans touch their dogs with physical touch and verbal praise, and they're not even realizing that they're actually reinforcing the unwanted behavior. So what can you do? You can do recall. Your dog recalls to you, give it affection. Your dog, teach it to do tricks, give it affection. And I get it. I know, no, dog training should be fun. I get that, but with a lot of dogs that we deal with, like, fun's like the last thing that's on their thing. If you try to give a dog too much affection, they can snap at you, or you get the dog so aroused, they break command. So, I mean, all depends. I do odor work with one of my dogs. When Kira finds a bomb, I let her jump up on my chest, and I, like, we hug it out, and I let her lick my face. I'm not against affection, guys. Like, don't get me wrong. I'm not against play. I'm not against affection. I'm not against sleeping with your dog. You know what I mean? But I need to know a lot more about that animal's behavior, and I need to know, are you making it worse or better? And then if I feel you're making it worse, I'll let you know, and then it's up to you. Next.
Melissa posted your website as well.
Awesome. Thanks.
Francine, just curious, why do you use clicker for puppies? Is it just for the early stages, and then do you move on to prong e collar?
Well, Francine, clicker is a great tool. We don't just use clicker for puppies. We use clicker training for aggressive dogs. Guys, 90% of our day is based on the word yes. Literally, 90% of our training day is based on the word yes at our training center. So right now we've got a couple dogs. We have, what, 7 dogs or 8 dogs in a boarding train? 7 dogs in a boarding train. A couple more coming in tomorrow. We usually max out at 9. 7 dogs. I bet you we say yes 1,000 times a day. Probably 1,000 times a day we say yes. So we do a ton of yes. So a clicker is a great marker. It's a great marker. Next.
Pam, you always mention not to give too much affection, and I've not heard the reason for that.
Oh, I talk about it all the time. I talk it all the time. Because too much affection could make dog. And I just sort of answered that question. Actually, a couple of questions ago. Hopefully you heard that, Pam. So a dog getting too much affection, then he creates horrific behaviors. We see it all the time. We see it all the time. Every dog that comes to us with massively, every time a dog comes to us with really bad behaviors, historically, has gotten too much affection. That's usually what it is. Not enough consequences, not enough structure, way too much affection. I can my level of expertise, which is lots, we're talking about over 4,000 dogs, and working with really hard and challenging dogs is based on my experiences with those dogs and my experiences with those owners. And I see a continuing, I talk about affection being bad all the time because most people do it at the wrong time. I'm not against affection though. But dogs are nervous and fearful. Here's a great example. Let me give you a good example. An owner comes in for the drop-off. They sit on a couch. If you followed us, you've seen tons of videos of that, photos and videos. Owners are there for the drop-off session. Dogs on the couch. The owner's on the couch. Sometimes the dog's on the couch. One of my staff members walks by. The dog growls. What do you think the owners do immediately? Immediately. Almost 100% of the time. Reach for the dog and pet the dog. And they say, it's okay. That's how you train a reactive, aggressive dog. Just like that. So I have a dog that does bite work. Guess how I trained her how to bite? To act aggressive. Love and affection. Play and toys. That's what I do. Have you ever seen her bite somebody? She's on an arm sleeve. That's my girl. Good job. When I give her the watch command, I'll say watch, and then she starts barking. Guess what I do? That's my girl. Good job. You find that bad guy. So imagine you don't want your dog to do those things. You're still doing the stuff that I'm doing, though, to reinforce the bad behavior. It happens all the time. There's two reasons why dogs misbehave. They've never been told not to, or they've been reinforced. The lack of a punisher is a reward, though. That's how it happens. So I talk about it actually every day. Next.
Taryn, what breed of dog do you feel is the hardest breed to train?
Hardest breed? I mean, sometimes we get some bulldogs in that are a little bit challenging, but they're probably more genetically, health-wise challenged. Any of your wolf hybrid dogs, which most people shouldn't own, those can be difficult. Some of these big, huge power breeds out of Russia, these dogs that they use for, like, you know, bear hunting, those can be challenging. I think if you understand motivation in a dog, both reward and punishment, you can pretty much work with any dog. Next.
Toxic Shiba. What do you do if you're confronted by an off-leash aggressive dog?
I kick the heck out of it.
He says we have a lot of off-leash dogs in our area.
Oh, then you should be carrying bear spray. Carry bear spray with you. Carry a hiking stick with you, a golf club. Not all of those things. You'll look ridiculous. You need a way to neutralize the threat. And if anybody has a hard time with this concept, you've never seen a dog killed in front of you by an off-leash dog, and I have. You know, I mean, it's horrific. It's literally horrific watching a dog kill another dog. It is the most horrific thing in the world, and guess what? It could take 3 seconds to do, especially if there's a major size differential. I've seen pack attacks, multiple dogs ganging up on one dog. It is horrific. So if any dog comes towards me, it is neutralized. And I'm not a violent person at all. I'm not talking about dog training anymore. I'm talking about survival. Yeah. There will be an injury. Someone will be injured. You, your dog, that dog. Someone's going to be injured. And it's becoming a major, major, major problem. A major problem. And so many people are not recognizing it. And it's really, really bad. It's just really bad. So that's what I would do. You need a way to neutralize threats. You got to come up with something next. But I would do something that the dog can't get close enough for you to do. So in order to kick a dog, the dog has to be close. But if that's all you have, kick. I want you to kick that dog with intent to harm. Okay? We don't kick dogs in training, guys. So don't take this soundbite and be like, oh, Jeff Gellman says kick dogs. Yet touch my kids? Like, you won't breathe anymore. And I would hope every single parent out there would feel the same way. I would really hope that every parent would feel the same way about protecting their children. protecting their children. Next.
Brandon says, thanks, Jeff. Sorry for the confusion. Contacting you now.
Awesome. Thanks, Brandon.
Cindy, can you swing the camera around so that we can see your new dog, please?
Cindy, I already did.
He's so awesome.
But nobody on Spotify can see it right there. That's Tex. We might change the name. That's Girl. And that's, I was just making sure things were reversed in this. And that's Kira. I've had that dog for this is my second night at the house. He was surrendered last Saturday when I was in Seattle. Yeah, he's been in the solid canine training world for a week. He did come to us as a past dog, though, a past client dog. Next.
Diana, for an 8-month-old, you suggested cutting down affection 2 hours on place. What else do you suggest for an 8-month-old owner?
I mean, tons of stuff. Tons. I mean, almost everything I've been talking about. So you watch all my do-it-yourself videos. So, okay, I'm a big advocate of this. I'm a big advocate of exercise, proper diet, and dog training. So, you know, what I would do is take your dog for structured walks, teach your dog how to sit, how to lie down, how to do place. And when I say sit, it's not trick sit. It's not just sit. Like sit and then like whatever. So down, long downs. You know, an 8-month-old dog is capable of doing 2-hour down easy, 2-hour place. Teach recall. Recall is the comeback command. Make sure your dog understands what the word no means. Obviously, you have to make sure you understand what the word yes means. That's how we train dogs to do what we want. They have to know what yes means. They have to know that what they did was right. It's called a marker. So we always use yes as a positive marker, and we use no as your punishment marker. So, I mean, teach your dog, if you want your dog to do certain tasks, if you want your dog to do tricks, you can do that afterwards. And a lot of dogs know paw, but they bite people. So paw is sort of useless at that point because that's not going to save their life. Teach your basics and then have some fun and teach whatever you want after that. Next.
Cece, how do you feel about giving dogs jobs, like wearing a backpack on walks?
I have no problem with that, Cece. None at all. Just make sure that the age of the dog, and you want to make sure that it's a proper fitting backpack. The backpack should fit up high. It should fit over the shoulders, not on the back, not on the spine area, up above the shoulders. And it's not supposed to be more than 25% of the dog's body weight, even though I used to go backpacking with my dogs. My dogs are athletes, and I definitely went over the 25%, you know, because we were backpacking the woods for over a week. So they carried, you know, they carried all, this is before I fed raw, they carried all their food. They carried all their food. So, and they carried some of my supplies as well. So I loaded them down pretty heavy. But they built up to it. So yeah, I'm a big advocate of jobs. Next.
Tatjana, knew it. Just need to hear it from you, Jeff. Thanks. I'm hitting my head all day because of it. Learned my lesson. Thank you.
Tatjana, guess what? I make mistakes every day. All right? I did. So don't worry about it. Okay.
Yeah. Taryn, if I'm training my dog in a dog-friendly public place and someone's service dog tries to attack mine, how do I converse with the handler of the service dog without looking like an a-hole?
So Taryn, no matter what you say, first of all, it's not a service dog, okay? It's not a service dog. No service dog behaves that way. It's a fake service dog. So there's a couple of things you can do. You can say, get your fake service dog out of here, right? Or you can not converse. You would think otherwise. I don't engage in conflict. I don't. Because I'm not interested. I'm not interested in those conversations. But if my dog was attacked by any dog, service dog or not, it would be a pretty much nonverbal conversation. And if somebody threw the, well, it's a service dog, I'm like, get your fucking money back because you got ripped off. Because no service dog attacks, let alone is reactive. A service dog is not reactive to humans. A service dog is not reactive to dogs. Technically, a therapy dog isn't either. So it's like, no. I don't care what your dog is. I don't care. If you, that's like, we'll go back, and I'll humanize shit all day long. I mean, let's all remember, okay? Okay, just remember who the Unabomber is, okay? I mean, he was effed up by the CIA, but he did go to Harvard at, 16 years old, I think he went to Harvard. He was messed up by the CIA. You can read his story. It's a pretty interesting, he's got a pretty interesting story on Kaczynski. But this is the thing. I don't care what someone's service dog is or their background is. What's your behavior? What's your behavior? Human and dog. Okay? I don't care if you went to Harvard. You're an asshole. Wow, you're really, really nice. You didn't make it through the eighth grade. Doesn't matter to me. You're a nice person. Next.
Continuation. She said, in 2 weeks, I had 3 dogs in Best Lunge try to attack my dog.
All right. And you got a lot of scam artists around you, Taryn. You got a lot of scam artists around you. Next.
Jake B., my dog doesn't lift her tail when on walk. In fact, most of the time, it's tail between legs. Best fix?
So this is the thing, Jake. Well, first of all, I mean, if it's a breed that has a lower tail, I guess there goes that theory. So your dog is nervous. You've got a nervous dog. So what can we do with the nervous dog? Some dogs are just nervous around environmentals. Some dogs just get really, really nervous around environmentals. So what do you got to do? You get to do some confidence building, right? So you do some confidence building. What can you do with that? We do a lot of climbing on things, going underneath things. We do agility equipment. It's not a aid frame. Find a playground. All food stuff, too, by the way. It's all food stuff. You can do engagement games. You can do stuff like that. But on the walk like you own the walk. You walk with confidence. Hold your dog accountable. Right now, don't allow your dog to make any of its own decisions, because unfortunately, those decisions might not be good for your dog. Your dog might not, you know, like. I'm sorry. Your dog might make bad choices. Next. It's an hour and 31 minutes into this. We gotta wrap it up. Next.
Brandon, he said, sorry, Jeff, I meant I have a trainer that is top 5, and I'm not comfortable with what I've seen today. He had a prong and knee collar and muzzled, and it was a mess.
Oh, sorry, Brandon. Sorry. I understand. CC, one more question, then we're out of here.
She says, all right, Jeff, we got to Skype soon. Me and Bear need you.
Awesome. Sounds good. All right, Greg, I'm on, what's today? Saturday, Monday at 7:30. We'll be back. All right. Joelle will be back too. All right. Love you guys.
Bye.
Spotify, SoundCloud, iTunes, Google, any other platform that's playing my show. I love you. YouTube Live. Thank you so much. I really, really appreciate it. Make sure you guys subscribe to my channel, and you can make sure you turn on your notifications. All right. Love you guys. Bye-bye.